Daily Morning Prayer, Tuesday, March 5th, 2024. If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in His presence, to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at His hands, to declare His most worthy praise, to hear His holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it. And his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation and said, it is a people that err in their hearts. They have not known my ways, or whom I swore in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. O come, let us adore him. The earth is the Lord's, and all that is in it, the compass of the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers of the deep. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, and who has not set his mind upon vanity, nor sworn to deceive his neighbor, he shall receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of those who seek him, even of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? It is the Lord, strong and mighty, even the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Unto you, O Lord, will I lift up my soul. My God, I have put my trust in you. O let me not be ashamed, neither let my enemies triumph over me. For all those who hope in you shall not be ashamed, but those who deal untruly shall be put to confusion. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me forth in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you has been my hope all the day long. Call to remembrance, O Lord, your tender mercies and your loving kindnesses, which have been from of old. O, remember not the sins and offenses of my youth, but according to your mercy, think on me, O Lord, in your goodness. Gracious and righteous is the Lord, therefore will he teach sinners in the way. Those who are meek shall he guide in judgment, and those who are gentle shall he teach his way. All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. For your name's sake, O Lord, forgive my sin, for it is great. Who is the one who fears the Lord? He shall teach him in the way that he shall choose. He shall dwell at ease, and his seed shall inherit the land. The Lord reveals his secret counsel to those who fear him, and he will show them his covenant. My eyes are ever looking to the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. Turn to me and have mercy on me, for I am desolate and in misery. The sorrows of my heart are enlarged. O, bring me out of my troubles. Look upon my adversity and misery, and forgive me all my sin. Consider my enemies, how many they are, and how they bear a tyrannous hate against me. O, keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be ashamed, for I have put my trust in you. Let integrity and righteous dealing preserve me, for my hope has been in you. Deliver Israel, O God, out of all his troubles. Be my judge, O God. Be my judge, O Lord, for I have walked innocently. My trust has been in the Lord, therefore I shall not fall. Test me, O Lord, and prove me. Examine my heart and my mind. For your loving kindnesses is ever before my eyes, and I will walk in your truth. I have not dwelt with evildoers, neither will I have fellowship with the deceitful. I have hated the company of the wicked, and will not sit among the ungodly. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, and so will I go to your altar, that I may lift up the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all your wondrous works. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house and the place where your honor dwells. O, take not away my soul with the sinners, nor my life with the bloodthirsty, those whose hands are full of wickedness and their right hand full of bribes. But as for me, I will walk innocently. O, deliver me and be merciful unto me. My foot stands firm. I will praise the Lord in the congregations. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus, beginning with the 12th chapter, the first verse. Now the Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall be the beginning of months for you. It is to be the first month of the year for you. Speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, on the 10th of this month they are each one to take a lamb for themselves according to the fathers' households, a lamb for each household. Now if the household is too small for a lamb, then he and his neighbor nearest to his house are to take one according to the number of persons in them, in proportion to what each one should eat. You are to divide the lamb. Your lamb shall be an unblemished male, a year old. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of the same month. Then the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel is to slaughter it at twilight. Moreover, they shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and on the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the flesh the same night, roasted with fire, and they shall eat it with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled at all with water, but rather roast it with fire, both its head and its legs along with its entrails. And you shall not leave any of it over until morning, but whatever is left of it until morning, you shall completely burn with fire. Now you shall eat it in this way, with your garment belted around your waist, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it in a hurry. It is the Lord's Passover. For I will go through the land of Egypt on that night and fatally strike all the firstborn of the land of Egypt, from the human firstborn to animals, and against all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague will come upon you to destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. Now this shall be a memorial for you, and you shall celebrate it as a feast to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you are to celebrate it as a permanent ordinance. For 7 days you shall eat unleavened bread, but on the first day you shall remove dough from yeast. You shall remove dough with yeast from your houses. For whoever eats anything with yeast from the first day until the seventh day, that person shall be cut off from Israel. And on the first day you shall have a holy assembly, and another holy assembly on the seventh day. No work at all shall be done on them except for what must be eaten by every person, that alone may be prepared by you. You shall also keep the feast of unleavened bread, for on this very day I brought your multitudes out of the land of Egypt. Therefore you shall keep this day throughout your generations as a permanent ordinance. In the first month, on the 14th day of the month at evening, you shall eat unleavened bread until the 21st day of the month at evening. For 7 days there shall be no dough with yeast found in your houses. For whoever eats anything with yeast, that person shall be cut off from the congregation of Israel, whether he is a stranger or native of a land. You shall not eat anything with yeast. In all your dwellings you shall eat unleavened bread. Then Moses called for all the elders of Israel and said to them, Go and take for yourselves lambs according to your families, and slaughter the Passover lamb. And you shall take a bunch of hyssop, and dip it in the blood which is in the basin, and apply some of the blood that is in the basin to the lintel and the two doorposts. And none of you shall go outside the door of his house until morning. For the Lord will pass through to strike the Egyptians, but when he sees the blood on the lintel and on the two doorposts, the Lord will pass over the Lord and will not allow the destroyer to come into your houses to strike you. And you shall keep this event as an ordinance for you and your children forever, when you enter the land which the Lord will give you, and he has promised you, as he has promised, you shall keep this rite. And when your children say to you, What does this rite mean to you? Then you shall say, It is a Passover sacrifice to the Lord, because he passed over the houses of the sons of Israel in Egypt when he struck the Egyptians, but spared our homes. And the people bowed low and worshipped. Then the sons of Israel went and did so, just as the Lord had commanded Moses and Aaron. So they did. Now it came about at midnight that the Lord struck all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, from the firstborn of Pharaoh, who sat on his throne, to the firstborn of the captive who was in the dungeon, and all the firstborn of cattle. And Pharaoh got up in the night, he and all his servants and all the Egyptians, and there was a great cry in Egypt, for there was no home where there was not someone dead. Then he called for Moses and Aaron at night and said, "Rise, rise up, get out from among my people, both you and the sons of Israel, and go worship the Lord as you have said. Take both your flocks and your herds as you have said, and go and bless me also." The Egyptians urged the people to send them out of the land in a hurry, for they said, "We will all be dead." So the people took their dough before it was leavened, with their kneading bowls bound up in the clothes on their shoulders. Now the sons of Israel had done according to the word of Moses, for they had requested from the Egyptians articles of silver and articles of gold and clothing, and the Lord had given the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they let them have their requests. Therefore they plundered the Egyptians. Now the sons of Israel journeyed from Ramses to Succoth, about 600,000 men on foot, aside from children. A mixed multitude also went up with them, along with flocks and herds, a very large number of livestock. And they baked the dough which they had brought out of Egypt into cakes of unleavened bread, for it had no yeast, since they were driven out of Egypt and could not delay, nor had they prepared any provisions for themselves. Now the time that the sons of Israel had lived in Egypt was 430 years, and at the end of 430 years, on this very day, all the multitudes of the Lord departed from the land of Egypt. It is a night to be observed for the Lord, for having brought them out of the land of Egypt, this night is for the Lord to be observed by all the sons of Israel throughout their generations. And the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "This is the ordinance of the Passover. No foreigner is to eat it. But as for every slave that someone has purchased with money, after you have circumcised him, then he may eat it. A stranger or a hired worker shall not eat it. It is to be eaten in a single house. You are not to bring any of the meat outside of the house, nor are you to break any bone of it. All the congregation of Israel are to celebrate this. But if a stranger resides with you and celebrates the Passover to the Lord, all of his males are to be circumcised, and then he shall come near to celebrate it, and he shall be like a native of the land. But no uncircumcised male may eat it. The same law shall apply to the native as to the stranger who resides among you." Then all the sons of Israel did so. They did just as the Lord had commanded Moses and Aaron. And on that very day the Lord brought the sons of Israel out of the land of Egypt, according to their multitudes. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew, beginning with the 15th chapter, the first verse. Then some Pharisees and scribes came to Jesus from Jerusalem and said, "Why do your disciples break the tradition of the elders? For they do not wash their hands when they eat bread." And he answered and said to them, "Why do you yourselves also break the commandment of God for the sake of your tradition? For God said, 'Honor your father and mother,' and the one who speaks evil of father or mother is to be put to death. But you say, 'Whoever says to his father or mother, whatever I have that would help you has been given to God,' he is not to honor his father or mother. And by this you have invalidated the word of God for the sake of your tradition. You hypocrites, rightly did Isaiah prophesy about you." by saying, "This people honors me with their lips, but their heart is far away from me, and in vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrines the commandments of men." After Jesus called the crowd to him, he said to them, "Hear and understand. It is not what enters the mouth that defiles the person, but what comes out of the mouth. This defiles the person." When the disciples came and said to him, "Do you know that the Pharisees were offended when they heard the statement?" But he answered and said, "Every plant which my heavenly Father did not plant will be uprooted. Leave them alone. They are blind guides of blind people, and if a person who is blind guides another who is blind, both will fall into a pit." Peter said to him, "Explain the parable to us." Jesus said, "Are you also still lacking in understanding? Do you not understand that everything that goes into the mouth passes into the stomach and is eliminated? But the things that come out of the mouth come from the heart, and those things defile the person. For out of the heart come evil thoughts, murders, acts of adultery, other immoral sexual acts, thefts, false testimonies, and slanderous statements. These are the things that defile the person, but to eat with unwashed hands does not defile the person." Jesus went away from there and withdrew into the region of Tyre and Sidon. And a Canaanite woman from that region came out and began to cry out, saying, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed." But he did not answer her with even a word. And his disciples came up and urged him, saying, "Send her away, because she keeps shouting at us." But he answered and said, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and began to bow down before him, saying, "Lord, help me." Yet he answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." And she said, "Yes, Lord, but please help, for even the dogs feed on the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus said to her, "O woman, your faith is great. It shall be done for you as you desire." And her daughter was healed at once. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord God, for you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain, for with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Heavenly Father, you have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Look with compassion upon the heartfelt desires of your servants, and purify our disordered affections, that we may behold your eternal glory in the face of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold, pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.